All right, so I've changed our latitude this time to 38 degrees south, and there's our meridian. The north celestial pole is actually below the horizon, so I can turn off the ground, and now we can reveal the celestial pole as being down there, you might say, down there toward the north. But I'll go ahead and just turn on the ground again, and let me reorient our view. We're going to turn around, and now we're facing south, and there is a south celestial pole, but there is not a bright star. And by the way, these patterns here, these are not actual constellations. They're what are called asterisms. In other words, these are just familiar patterns in the sky that people readily identify with, at least in this case for people living in the southern hemisphere. The Big Dipper is not a constellation. It's actually part of a larger constellation, Ursa Major, the Great Bear. Ursa Major is the proper constellation. The Big Dipper is just an asterism. So I'm going to go ahead and switch off these asterisms and allow time to move forward. Now, this seems kind of strange, doesn't it? It looks like everything's going the wrong direction, but keep in mind we are now facing the southern celestial pole. Stars are still rising in the east. They are still transiting the meridian at some point, and they are still setting in the west. But as you now know, we are somewhere south of the equator, and so things at first blush seem to be reversed, but they really aren't. So let's go ahead and reorient ourselves to due south one more time. There we go. From this latitude at 38 degrees south, the south celestial pole is 38 degrees above the southern horizon. So once again, the altitude of the pole is going to be equal to your latitude on Earth. It's just a question of which pole happens to be above your horizon. If we tilt up, there is a very bright and well-known constellation known as Crux. You've probably have heard the song Southern Cross by Crosby, Stills, and Nash. There's a great line that says, "When you see the Southern Cross for the first time, you understand now why you came this way." Well, Crosby, Stills, and Nash were living in the Northern Hemisphere, so clearly they had to set sail for some latitude south of their location in order to see the Southern Cross for the first time. Let's see if we can do the same thing. So if we return to Baltimore and we look for the Southern Cross, it simply isn't there. It's not even above the horizon and never will be. On the other hand, if we were to set sail for a point someplace in the Caribbean, the Southern Cross will appear at some point above this horizon. And now we understand just why we came this way.